What up, big kids? I got a new car!
Oh yeah, let's ride.
To the Batmobile! Batman! Action figures, Batman. BigBadToyStore.com has all our classic action figures. Go to BigBadToyStore.com. Link is in the description. Old chum.
Love it, kids. It's time for your
big review. What up, big kids? Here's your big review: the Batman classic TV series Batmobile from Mattel. We got the packaging, which is a very cool retro-looking packaging. It has the classic Batman classic TV series logo. Says the Batmobile. DC Comics logo has a nice picture of the Batmobile right there while window box showing in. And you can see in the background is the Batcave, which is very cool if you can tell. And it says, first Batman Classic TV series Batmobile fits 6-inch figures, woo! And it fits most 6-inch Batman Classic figures. You can see the top of the box has a little window display, but it also has the bat signal. You can see on the sides of the box has some really cool Batman and Robin art that says Rome. Back of the packaging has a picture of Batman and Robin with the Batmobile. It has a nice little bio to the Batmobile. Talks about Batman and Robin, the dynamic duo. Feel free to pause and read it. Talks about how the Batmobile was designed by George Barris. And you can see it also shows other Batman figures with same Bat Time, same Bat Channel, featuring Batman, the Joker, the Penguin, the Riddler, Catwoman, and Surf's Up Batman. Old chum, to the Batmobile! And here we got the Batman Classic TV series Batmobile! Really cool. I just wish I had a little bit more going on with it, but let's take a closer look. This is my third favorite Batmobile, the first being the Batman 1989, the second being the Batman Animated Series. I do love this Batmobile a lot. I do love the classic 60s look. Mattel did do some good jobs with, you know, having the bat emblems on the rims. They are plastic tires though, which I do wish they were rubber, you know, for the price. I always love rubber tires. I do love the nice orange trim. The paint, for the most part, is pretty clean. There is some smears on mine. I do like the Batman symbol right there. You know, it's pretty, like, it's just mostly plastic. Very hollow. If you've seen Pixel Dan's review, you know that this is very, very light and very, very hollow. You know, not much going on here. This is not any die-cast metal whatsoever. Always like the front of the Batmobile. One thing you notice, I do wish it had some like translucent plastic for the headlights. It'd been cool if they did that. But you know, it's still pretty cool. I do like the clear windshield right there, and it has this little radiator thing. I don't know what that is, but it's still cool. You know, very cool from both sides, you know, like a Batman symbol, and you know, rolls really good. That's what the main thing this thing does, it rolls. I do love the exhaust pipes on the back here. That is so cool, and they're rubbery plastic, so you won't have to worry about poking any kids' eyes out, and translucent plastic right here. You know, we also got the license plate 2F3567. If that means anything, that's really cool, but I don't think it does. I don't think that was, they planned that far ahead. And yeah, there's no like little, I wish I had a little cool flame exhaust thing coming out here. The silver is pretty nice, I do have to admit. I wish this thing did have some lights and sounds, especially for the price. You know, 50 bucks, you would think it would. This is also very rubbery, this little siren thing. And it, you can see it says emergency bat turn lever. And it has the bat fire hydrant, which, you know, it's just stuck on there. I wish it was removable. And it does have a little lever in here that's very rubbery. It does have a steering wheel that turns, so that's cool. And one thing you do notice, it does have the bat phone in there. But once again, I do wish it was removable. It would be cool if you can display Batman being on the phone on there. That's cool. It does have real seat belts, but these things don't work as well as I like them. You know, they do insert right there for both sides. I do like that they have bat emblems on there. And the seats are just plastic. It's just really plasticky, and yeah, just very hollow. Big selling point on this Batmobile versus other ones that Mattel has done, like from Hot Wheels, is that you can fit 6-inch figures. Now, this of course works with Batman, Robin, or any of really any of these figures, especially that they have cloth capes, because that's why they made them with the cloth capes, so they can put in there. So you would just position him, you know, just put, lift up the seatbelt, and then you can decide if you want the cape to be like flown in the wind, or you just kind of bunch it up. This works better with the other Batman. It doesn't have the wire in it, because these wires are freaking annoying when it comes to sitting them down. Now here's the thing, they fit really well, you can see, looks good, but you know, the big thing is that these seatbelts are really hard to get in there correctly because of the capes. So you kind of have to like line it up, and then it just becomes very monotonous trying to do it. I just kind of like tuck it onto the side and it looks okay. Put Batman and Robin here very nicely. Like I said, the seatbelts, as you can see here, just get really annoying. They're just really hard to fully clip in just because of these capes. It wouldn't be as hard if without the wire, but you know, whatever, they're superheroes, they don't have to abide by the law, they don't need seatbelts. You're probably wondering, does this Batmobile fit other 6-inch figures? Yes and no. Now, let's take out Robin, because screw Robin. You can put like other ones. I'm going to put a character you'll never see in there unless he's very sergeant. You could put like Marvel Legends Iron Man in here. He's a little bit big, but you can see he fits. He looks cool. You know, I don't know why he would be in his Iron Man armor and in the Batmobile, but whatever, I'm just showing for example. Definitely works for other Mattel 6-inch figures, like you can put the Dark Knight Rises Catwoman here. Yeah, I know it's not Julie Newmar or Eartha Kitt or even Lee Merriweather, but freaking Catwoman's been 3 different actresses, so why not? But yeah, you can see it works perfectly for Catwoman. Now here's the thing, you won't be able to fit any figure that has these kind of plasticky capes. Like whether it's the Man of Steel Superman or other Batman figures like the Dark Knight Rises Batman. He could fit in here, but because of this freaking cape, you either have to have it like flown out like in a very awkward way, or yeah, it's like, yeah, he's a little bit, this guy is a little bit smaller than he should fit, but yeah, this cape is really making him like he just wants to like feel the wind in his hair, Batman, or his cowl, or his ears. And then of course, with big old bulky capes like Superman here, this won't work at all. This is why, kids, I say I love cloth capes, because Mattel never thought far ahead to think about this. This is why CM Punk doesn't need a cape, he's best in the world! Size comparison time. So here you can see that this Batmobile compared to other Batmobiles meant for 6-5-inch figures, it's definitely pretty big. It's bigger than the old Kenner Bat Missile from Batman Returns, as well as the Mattel Tumbler launcher from the Dark Knight. And then yeah, you can see how much bigger it is, and this is definitely made for 6-inch scale figures. This one is pretty much just made for your 6-inch classic Batman figures and to roll around. For me, I would love if this had some die casts or rubber tires or lights and sounds, or just had some removable props from the you know, like the extinguisher and the phone. I know that would drive the price up, because this is already, you know, $50 as it is, and it's a Toys R Us exclusive. I would love for it to have, even if it was a little bit more money, but if you're gonna get this, you are getting this for your figures. Other, because like I said, there's better versions of the 66 Batmobile, you know, like the Hot Wheels, Elite ones. Hot Toys is gonna make a freaking Batmobile that will be better than this. But you know, for $50, it's not that bad. You know, like I said, I just wish it had more to offer. It's great for putting, you know, putting figures in there, especially ones that have cloth capes or no capes, or, you know, the figures that it's made for. For that, I recommend it, but if you're wanting a better just display piece of only a Batmobile, I recommend getting the Hot Wheels one or the Hot Toys one. For more geek news, reviews, podcasts, more, go to BKBN.net. I'm Sean Long, remember, celebrate your room in a big way.
All right, check out BKBN.net. Jason David Frank, Tommy the Green Ranger.
Old school Batmobile, I want to ride. Can't get in here, my freaking cape, what a drag.
Sorry, old chum, but this is made for Batman, not Batman. Will the Christian Bale Batman get inside the Batmobile? Is his cape really a drag? Could he spare to lose a few pounds? Find out next time, same bat time, same bat channel. Where's that voice coming from? Where is he?